Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to do a review after owning this Acer Chromebook 15 for 2.5 years. So let's get started with the mini lesson. So let's go on and see why did I choose this particular model of the Acer Chromebook 15. They make a few different models. There's one that's kind of a silvery iron color. And that one is available. That's also a 15.6 inch screen, so it's a nice large screen. The difference is the processor. So I made this little chart showing the gray model here. That's called the CB3-532, and then comparing that to the CB5-571. CPU on the gray one here is the Intel Celeron N3060 running at 1.6 gigahertz. And the one that I have there is the Intel Celeron 3205U running at 1.5 gigahertz. And you go, well, Mr. Barry, no, the gray one has a faster processor. It runs at 1.6 gigahertz. And the white one has a slower processor. It runs at 1.5 gigahertz. There you go. Case closed. Not really. I go to places and do my research. So I went to www.cpubenchmark.net, and what they do is they test all these processors. Now this particular Celeron processor scores at 993, so that's a score that it received. And doing the same test, this processor scores at 1542, so that is a significant improvement in the performance. The RAM amount is only 2 gigs for the gray one, and then it's 4 gigs for the white one here. And then the solid state drive, it's 16 gigs for the gray one and 32 gigs for this particular one that I bought. They do make a version of this white one that comes with a smaller 16 gig hard drive. And then for prices, well, I found the gray one for $140 on sale at Groupon. The price varies. Sometimes it goes all the way down to about $125, and sometimes all the way up to about $170 at that location. For the white one, as cheap as I could find it right today was $170 at blinks.com. And again, the price varies. I go to these things a lot. I buy a lot of them for my students. And so yes, the price does vary considerably. The lowest I've ever seen the white one was about $140, and that was for a short sale. The highest was $450. So yeah, that's a pretty big variance in price. I've owned both of these, and what I've noticed with the CB3 is it's slightly laggy when I have all of my 32 or so tabs up there. And I'll be doing my video recording from the webcam and doing my video editing with other things up. Yes, this one would be a little bit slower, and I could notice that. Whereas on this one, it never slowed down. The CB5 was always very fast, and I enjoyed working with it. I'd click on something and it'd pop right away and do the work. Other kind of work that I do with these, besides my video recording, I'd also be doing editing of my books, my lecture notes, and my lessons, all on these machines using Google Docs, Google Sheets, and also using slides. Now I do have the online version of Microsoft Office, and I used to do everything in Microsoft Office, but since then I've dropped all that and I've gone to Google Docs, and I'm not going back. I really like the features that I found in Google Docs, and they've added a lot more to them in the last few years. So if you haven't tried Google Docs recently, please try ahead and look at all the features. You do have WordArt now, and you have a huge categories of clip art and images. You could do everything that you could do in Microsoft Office. I even have a way to do dual columns now and everything else I could do in Word. So I'm very, very happy with Google Docs. Now, as far as the basic things such as watching videos, doing my social media, calling people, talking to people on the phone with the Chromebooks. These two machines were both the same. They were on par with each other. The only time that I noticed a difference was when I was doing my video editing and video processing. The white one here, the CB5, was much faster than the gray one. So who would I recommend this machine to? Well, you can see in my chart there, the average user, yes. The average user being someone who uses YouTube, does email, does Facebook, uses Skype, Hangouts, uses their computer to make phone calls with, video calls, video chats with. They go in and they edit their Word documents or their Google documents. They go in and they work with Excel spreadsheets or their Google Sheets or Google Slides and PowerPoint presentations. All those things work great on this. I've been using these Chromebooks for 2.5 years, and I create all my books, my lessons, my lecture notes, including even those the last year's, all my videos were all done with this very Chromebook. So they work great for doing all those things. Where they're lacking, of course, would be on the 3D gamer side. I can't install professional software. So if I want to do real high-end video editing, then I'm going to be using a Windows machine. If I want to play GTA or Battlefield 5 and all those other wonderful first-person shooter games, guess what? I'm going to be playing them on a Windows machine, period. I'm not going to be using a Chromebook for that kind of things. So in my universe, I use two computers. When I want to sit down, relax, watch YouTube videos, when I want to edit my documents and do some of my video editing, well, guess what? I'm using this Chromebook here. When I want to go in and create a level within Gore Script and do some really heavy playing in games, then I'm going to be using my nice Windows machine. It has a purpose for that. So it really depends on the type of user and what you're going to be doing it with. One really wonderful thing about these is that they're so portable. Their weight is about 4.85 pounds, so it's just light enough, you might say, to be very portable. I take this around all around the house with me. The screen is just large enough for me to be able to sit back and watch things and do my work. I have owned 11-inch Chromebooks. I even have 13-inch and 14-inch Chromebooks still. And those screens, you can tell, they're a little bit smaller, so it's harder to do my work on those. Whereas the bigger screen is just, it's roomier. I love it. All right, now let's look at something that I didn't really like about these is they pick up dirt really easily. The gray one, I've had those too. And they don't get dirty. I mean, if they do, you just don't notice it. Well, this one, if you simply put your finger onto it, it leaves a little brown spot. There it is. So these get dirty super, super quick. This is just after about 6 months or so of dirt piling up on this one. This side is clean. My wife uses hers every day too to listen to online radio all day long, and then later, she'll watch her Drama Crazy YouTube. She'll also do Facebook as well as doing other things. She does all those things, and this machine has been a faithful little worker for her. Back to mine. So if you don't mind cleaning up the clamshell every month or so, hey, there you go. You can go with this one. Next topic is battery life, and it's been very consistent at about 9 hours. So we charge these up during the night, and then we use them all day long. And like I said, it's around 9 hours. And even after 2.5 years, it's still very consistently charged and works for 9 hours. So there you have it. An owner's review of the Acer Chromebook 15. After 2.5 years of owning it and using it every day. And believe me, we've used them hard. One thing I'd like to add though before I close, the one that my wife uses, it's been dropped, milk has been spilled on it, it's been kicked around a lot. Let's see, what else has happened to it? It's fallen off the table many times. And guess what? It still works. Check this out. Here we go. There you go, that's the splash screen. And there you go, so it boots up. And then she would type in her password and get into her Google account. So yeah, it works great. If you're watching this on YouTube, please give it the thumbs up there. Comment down below and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. Also, I'd like to remind everyone that I have hundreds of other videos on topics about Chromebooks, Windows machines, on doing all kinds of things with technology, both with mobile devices and also the larger devices as well. So please check out those as well. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.